Anyway, I haven't talked for a long time. And what am I doing? I'm taking the back garden, the front garden too eventually, but the back garden, and I'm rearranging its structure, making a garden with all kinds of varieties of plants and vegetables, so, and flowers. So it's been kind of a work in progress to take the sod away, rearrange it, and just be happy I don't have sod, so much sod. And so yeah, that's what I'm doing. And then it's fun to be back outside, outdoors like this, because there I was, I'm making a design space of this where I'm going to plant some beets and some turnips, and I'm like, well, right there I'm going to make a rainbow area. So I'm like, oh yes, cool, I'm making a rainbow. So I was working on like these little silly rainbow lines for like an hour, and then just after I finished, you know, that I was done, I watered it in, I put all the mulch down, and I was like all pretty much content with it. I was done for the day. I look up at the sky. I look up the sky, and there is a cloud. And it was a funny cloud, because it was just laughing at me. It was a cloud shaped exactly like a rainbow. I am not kidding. And it's sort of just like, and it was the beet colored hues of just what I had planted there as well. So, you know, when they come to maturity. So it was like a freak event, but not a freak event. It's actually a live event every moment, every minute, if you listen. If you participate in this planet, it pays you back just with that gift. So yeah. So the rainbow, I was there just like, you know, just some manual labor worker, you know. And then the clouds just laughed at me and said, haha, we can be manual labor worker also. So that's what's been going on. I am very excited. I'm going to go with watermelons and cantaloupes and all kinds of interesting things that grow in hot regions. I'm going to make a tiny garden that has as many vegetables as possible, as a, what do we call it, like, can it be done? Yeah, it's that kind of thing. How much can you actually grow on a tiny plot in a city? It's that type of event. And yet, without being crammed and actually enjoy it. So I have two doves also that live there in the garden already. They live actually not in it. They live in the neighborhood, the neighborhood tree, and they're just in love. Two doves in love, and that's amazing. They see each other, and the one goes up to the other, and they do their little thing, and then they flit off. But they meet every night at the same time in that tree. And so that's always cool, isn't it? Yeah. The animals have that bond with each other. It's just a beautiful thing, you know. Anyway, so that's where I'm at. And I got some free mulch. We have free mulch from the city, so that was good. I got free mulch. What else did I get? Yeah, I'm trying to go organic on everything, so I can't really use that mulch everywhere. I can only use it in certain areas, like maybe for fruit trees, but when you're thinking about organic only, it's really, you're back to your own compost, making your own compost. from your food scraps, and etc. And yeah, I don't have a little miniature Shetland pony, but that would be funny. That would be funny if I could have a little mini Shetland pony back there, but there's not enough space. That's the way life goes sometimes. Yeah, so it's kind of a challenge. It's a challenge garden, and with that, it's exciting because I don't want the crammed in feeling, and yet I want it to be, because I want it to be a quiet space. Even though it's a garden growing all these things, I want it to be a quiet space, a tame space, where the mind collects itself and finds peace in that discovery. Anyway, so that's where I'm at with some strange things with my camera, but I think it works.